Welcome to EnggClasses YouTube channel. In this video, we'll consider an example on Z transform. The task is to determine its Z transform and what is the ROC. For that, what I do is I'll consider a simple example. Let X of n is equal to alpha to the power n u of n. So this is the given signal X of n. The task is to find what is its Z transform. So I represent that with X of Z. So what is the Z transform and what is the region of convergence? So I denote it as ROC. So I need to find two things. For that, I already know that the expression for Z transform, that is X of Z, is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity till infinity X of n z to the power minus n. So that is the formula to find the z transform. So in this equation, what I do is I'll substitute for x of n. X of n, it is given as alpha to the power n and u of n. So I substitute that. So let the limit summation n equal to minus infinity till infinity, in place of x of n, I'll put alpha to the power n u of n z to the power minus n. Now, I know that the signal u of n is an unit step signal. So, it is already known u of n is an unit step signal. And if I want to denote that signal, so it exists from 0 till infinity. And the amplitudes are 1. It's unity amplitude. So, this is u of n with respect to n. Amplitude is 1, starting from 0, extending till infinity. So this signal exists from 0 to infinity. Alpha to the power n exists from minus infinity to plus infinity. But that signal is getting multiplied with u of n, which only exists from 0 to infinity. Hence, the limits of the above summation will change from, so earlier it was minus infinity, now it becomes 0 to infinity. Because u of n exists only from 0. Hence, the limit got changed from 0 to infinity. Alpha to the power n, u of n is 1. In that range, u of n, the amplitude is 1. So, I will not write that. So, multiplied with z to the power minus 1. So, now I try to combine them. I will write it as summation n equal to 0 to infinity, alpha z to the power minus 1 whole to the power n. So, I'll just rearrange it in this format so that I can use the result of the geometric series. So, the geometric series says that summation n equal to 0 to infinity alpha to the power n is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus alpha, provided magnitude alpha is less than 1. So, I can make use of this result. So, now this summation is in that form so that I can write 1 divided by 1 minus alpha into z inverse. So this is the z transform X of z. So whenever I'm writing the result of geometric series, at that step only I'll write what is its ROC. So ROC is region of convergence, where this infinite sum is going to converge. So that's what I need to find. So for that I look for this alpha z inverse. So alpha z inverse, the magnitude of this must be less than 1. So this is the region of convergence. That means if I make this magnitude of alpha z inverse less than 1, I'm going to get a finite value for X of z. That means it is going to converge. Or else if I make alpha z inverse equal to 1 here, so what is 1 divided by 1 minus 1? As good as 1 divided by 0, which is equal to infinity. That means the sum is not going to converge. For that, what I do is I'll make it less than 1. So then only it is going to converge. So I'll just, only thing is I need to simplify it further. For that, what I do is I'll just write it over here. X of z is equal to, so z inverse I'll write as alpha divided by z. And I take it to the numerator, hence it becomes z divided by z minus alpha is x of z. What is its ROC? So for that, what I do is I'll write alpha divided by z, magnitude of this must be less than 1. So I'll write it, I'll take z to RHS, so it becomes alpha less than z. So ROC must always be in terms of z, so mod z greater than alpha. So this is what the ROC is. So that is the ROC. So once the ROC is found, the only thing is I need to represent it using a graph. So for that, what I do is I'll simply write x-axis and y-axis. So let y-axis be imaginary of z, and I'll represent x-axis as real of z. So in that, I'll draw a circle. I'll draw a circle and let the radius of this b is alpha. So as per my ROC, what it says is mod z greater than alpha. So whatever the value of z greater than alpha, so it comes over here. So these are the values that is greater than alpha. So this is what the ROC is. That's it. So in this example, we considered x of n as alpha to the power n u of n. We found its ROC. We found its z transform. X of z equal to z divided by z minus alpha is the z transform. And what is its ROC? Mod z greater than mod alpha is its ROC. And if I want to indicate it, I indicate it in this way. So this is all about an example on z transform. Thanks for watching.